Now there's a worthy prize, if only 'twern't so far away.
Gather round, treat your ears to a tale by its master storyteller.
Hoi, friend. Klaus sent word that you've agreed to rescue some of my pilfered equipment. I'd be grateful for aught you can reclaim. True.
Fair warning. Goblins are behind these oxcart raids, I've since learned. No doubt they're hoarding the stolen arms in their den. From the tell of it, their lair lies somewhere along the western road. Pray do be careful. If aught were to go awry, 'twould weigh heavily on my heart. Losing my wares for good would make me sore. But no sack of gold can compare to a fellow life, eh?
Gather round, treat your ears to a tale by...
Very useful ingredients to be gathered here, I'll wager.
No harm in picking a few. Break it from this side.
I understand. Let me get that.
'Tis about time we pressed on, wouldn't you say, Master?
No sense letting the enemy gain the upper hand. The early griffin gets the worm, as they say.
I grant your weapon a magical boon. You have my protection. I'll combine my magic with yours, that you might cast the spell more quickly.
Naught compares to the thrill of victory. One cannot help but feel indomitable.
Overconfidence is an enemy in and of itself. Let us instead strive to better ourselves with every battle.
I did not know I could feel so alive. Perhaps this will seem of little consequence, but
different masters favor different pawns. One whom I serve preferred to have beasts for allies.
To their own? It was excellent. I could have done no better.
Perhaps you'd like to take care of the remainder.
I concur. lest victory slip away from us.
Very well, if I must.
I only hope I did not
pin the fiend in place.
I concur. You are in need of healing. Allow me. Wait a moment. Let my magics grant you an elemental boon. Common reward. Frustratingly so.
We'll find a use for it, I'm sure.
Battles atop bridges are best avoided.
It seems safe enough, at least.
I am well aware of the particulars. A fine place to harvest some ingredients. Shall we see if there's aught to be found while we're here?
Thank you.
Naught like a feast to get you ready for bed.
Good sleep is the key to a good adventure.
I am attentive and loyal, and prefer to remain by your side. In battle, I shall follow your lead and prioritize support. Freshly rested as we are, this battle ought to be in our favor. We must not let down our guard. Quickly, Arisen, you must regain your footing. Let my magics grant you an elemental boon. Attack now, while the ogre's attention is fixed on its favorite prey. Do hurry. This foe is taught to women as a moth to a flame.
It is a tendency we might exploit. To do so would be to cause danger.
Naught compares to the thrill of victory. One cannot help but feel indomitable.
Overconfidence is an enemy in and of itself. Let us instead strive to better ourselves.
Now, what might that be?
Let us ponder how best to proceed.
Really now, you mustn't shirk your duty. Lest you forget, 'tis the Arisen we serve here.
No sense letting the enemy gain the upper hand. The early griffin gets the worm, as they say.
When calm, be sure to avoid open flame.
Ingredients are plentiful hereabouts.
No harm in picking a few. That reminds me. We've not counted a thief among our number for some time.
We've no need of a thief. if we are content to overwhelm our foes with sheer force.
Having more of these to hand ought serve us well in battle.
What say we pelt one at the next foe we encounter?
I should be glad to assist you, Arisen. Goblins, Master! No! The Arisen has been poisoned!
Is hard as stone, making it ideal for tossing it at other foes.
We are none of us alike in vocation.
It's a tad inconvenient. We can't share equipment.
Let us utilize our individual strengths wherever possible.
A fell poison is working its evil effects upon the Arisen. Thank you.
are to retreat, then?
Little does our foe realize how narrowly they escaped death's touch. Arisen, you are full of surprises. I look forward to performing my own masterful expectation.
Now that is a surprise. The product of heedlessness.
I cannot help you. Is anyone else available?
It shall be done. I am here to aid you, Arisen. I suppose there can be no harm in bringing this along.
We'll find a use for it, I'm sure.
No! The prison has been poisoned! Elemental boom. I should be glad to assist you, Arisen. I'll collect that. You needn't trouble yourself.
certainly arisen. How might I be of aid? You called? Forgive me, but you do not appear to be in need of aid.
Come to think of it, different masters favor different pawns. One whom I served preferred to have beastruns for allies.
Each to their own. Arisen, to me. I shall heal you. Wait a moment. Yon oxcart is broken beyond repair.
The roads are hardly safe.
We must remain vigilant.
That blackguard found you somewhere.
A profitable endeavor. It shall be done. I am here to aid you, Arisen. Mind.
I think I get the idea.
Glad to assist you, Arisen. Thank you. Yes, Master. I shall hasten to your aid. This is generally used as a material.
Different combinations of materials result in different creations.
I grant your weapon a magical boon. Let me get that.
Let us see what you're made of. This creature is hard as stone, making it ideal for tossing at our other foes.
Product of your heedlessness.
It's called taking the initiative. I'll have you.
I grant you roaring flame.
over so soon? Why, we seem to have come through unscathed.
We've got them on the run.
Let them run. We need not waste our strength.
Have we met, sirs? You seem familiar somehow. My, you're back! And not a day too soon.
This rumor has been troubling me ever since I first caught wind of it. Apparently, there is an illness we pawns can catch beyond the rift that makes us a danger to ourselves and others. Symptoms include an unruly attitude and overconfidence.
And in the end, we turn our backs on our master and our duty.
Indeed. But we shall have to remain watchful, lest one of our company should start showing signs of this sickness. No rest for the weary, it seems. We will be hard-pressed to find victory here if we cannot heal our wounds. You'll like to grow overburdened if you keep picking up every little trinket you find. Let my magics grant you an elemental boon!
There are useful ingredients to be gathered here, I'll wager.
Shall we see if there's aught to be found while we're here?
I could look upon this sky for all eternity. It wasn't for the crick in my neck.
Keep gazing upward, and you'll like to stumble ere long. Fight our enemies.
brute has quite the temper.
Might we not use their rage to our advantage?
It is easily done.
I thought you might like this, so I picked it up. Here you go.
I'll carefully conserve my strength and endeavor to survive every battle by way of sound strategy and defensive.
What was that?
How goes it? Care to hear an old man's request? Aye, you've my gratitude.
I'll collect that. You needn't trouble yourself.
Must you run so fast? I can hardly keep you in my sights, Arisen.
Let us endeavor to keep up, though we are less fleet of foot.
I grant you roaring flame.
A common reward. Frustratingly so.
We'll find a use for it, I'm sure.
Now we've the vim to tackle the day ahead.
Off we go, then.
I don't know about you, but I am full of vim and vigor. Alas, 'twould seem I've taken on too much.
Perhaps 'tis time we returned to our base of operations and deposited some of our finds.
Such beasts are a fair source of meat, when rations are lacking.
Ingredients are plentiful hereabouts.
No harm in picking a few.
I don't know about you, Master, but I'm worn out. Mightn't we have a rest before pressing on?
Is there no getting through this door?
Thank you.
you to refrain from charging off. Teamwork is the crux of our strategy.
Don't be such a worry, Warp. I know what I'm doing.
Use these flames to smite our enemies.
Aye, you've my gratitude. Here you are. Reckoned I owed you something.
Take this. 'Tis something I found. I wanted you to have it. I've a knack for gathering items, and am ever on the hunt for new finds. I'll gladly try out any useful mechanisms I espy.
That's it. I've had enough. Clear off. And don't come back till you're ready to do business properly.
But I've got the coin. I swear it. I simply just...
Where is it then, eh? Bring the coin. All of it. Or I'll call the sentinels on you again. Are we clear?
'Tis uncommon for a...
Oh, 'tis you. You're the good sir who aided me in Malv. Thank you again, sir. You don't know how grateful I am to you.
Well met, sir. Forgive my presumption, but were you the one who gave my granddaughter that medicine in Melv? I thought so. She's not stopped talking of her adventure since she arrived home. You have my sincerest thanks for aiding her. That girl's always running off on some fool's errand or other, for all my chiding. Once she gets an idea under her bonnet, there's simply no talking her out of it. Now listen, 'tisn't much, but I'd fain offer you a discount on my wares. Pray, make good use of it, won't you? Welcome and well met. Don't think I've forgotten your discount now. I'll knock a few gold pieces off. fought you by. So spend...
Always a pleasure.
Well, it takes two to me.
I've brought you a gift. Will you accept it?
This really is...
Oh! Tis you! You're a welcome sight. Forgive my boldness, but I've a small fa- Would you be willing to lend me some gold? I swear you'll be repaid in full. A trinket in yon shop caught my eye. A small, ornate box of exceptional craftsmanship. Alas, 'twould seem I do not have the coin on hand to purchase it. I can certainly procure the gold later, but by then, the box might be gone. If you'd be kind enough to lend me the amount I need, I would repay every last coin.
Look, Master, a treasure chest. We shall have to find a way to reach it.
Welcome and well met. Don't think I've forgotten your discount. Do come again.
Yes? Is there aught I can do for you? Or could it be that you've reconsidered my request? You bought it for me. Thank you. I'll treasure this. You're a kind soul. Pray, let me return the favor someday.
He spoke of returning the...
Here you are. Reckoned I owed you something.
Apart from my joints, I've not to complain of.
Gather round.
What did you think of that story? It was well told and all, but not particularly exciting, eh? I mean, it's the sort of thing you hear bandied about the tavern every other night, isn't it? I'd heard tell of a beggar doing well for himself, so I came out here to learn his ways. Haven't learned much, that's for sure. And by the look of it, he doesn't appear to be making much for his efforts, neither. So where's all his coin coming from, then? Makes a man wonder, it does.
Gather round, treat your ears to a tale, by